Good evening, everyone.
This evening, we celebrate the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. I invite you all to please stand and join in singing Immaculate Mary, which is not in our, and nor the same nor is our accent, which is Hail Holy Queen. But I thank you, Immaculate Mary.
With the moon beneath her feet
and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod, and her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of God, and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leapt in her womb. And Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months, and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord. There is a true story about a poor boy, a poor young man who grew up in Los Angeles. As a teenager, he became very interested in boxing and showed that he had exceptional talent as a boxer. Were it not found for that newfound interest, it's likely that he would have drifted off into a life of crime, as had so many of his companions, so many in his neighborhood. The most significant person in this young man's life was his mother, and it was his mother who encouraged him in this new pursuit. It was his mother who encouraged him and went to all of his fights, their presence, their wanting to give him that kind of support that he needed. Well, he was selected to box for America in the Barcelona Olympics of 1992. He was thrilled, but sadly, when he went to the Olympics, his biggest fan, his mother, wasn't there to see him represent his country because she had died a short time before the games began. She had a terrible illness and was suffering from it for quite a while. The story is told that she would put off treatments as long as she could, if she could only get to his next fight. And after a period, the illness just took her life. But even in his grief, he was certainly all the more determined to win that gold medal for her sake. And he did. He won the gold medal. And in that moment of triumph, the moment of winning the gold medal, he didn't forget his mother. Because the very first thing that he did after the verdict was announced was to get down on his knees in the middle of the ring, before the television cameras, before all those people watching. And he said a prayer, and looking up to heaven, we are told his prayer was, Ma, this is for you. I owe it to you. She had been the center of his efforts, the center of his life, the center of his struggle from the beginning. And he wanted to share his glory with her. He wanted to share his glory, his triumph, with her. Today, as we honor Mary in the Assumption, we know that she was with Jesus from the very beginning, and she stayed with him right to the end. She was beside him in all the joyful and sorrowful moments of his life. She brought him into the world, in the stable in Bethlehem. She brought him into Egypt when it was clear Herod was on the path to kill all of the infants. She brought him back to Nazareth, and she and Joseph raised that child in their home. She saw him grow up. She sought him when he was lost in the temple, frantic to find her child. During his public ministry, she no doubt feared for his safety, for his security. And she accompanied him, as we know, all the way to Calvary, and was with him as he was hanging on that cross. As he died, she was with him till the end. And so it is in many ways right, it is in many ways fitting that she should share in his glory. She was with him throughout all aspects of his life. And so when we celebrate this great solemnity, this wonderful celebration of the Assumption, we are in a way celebrating Mary sharing the triumph, the victory of her son. And it gives us encouragement. Because like Mary, we travel on this earth. What she attained, this place of honor, this place of privilege, sharing in that glory and triumph, it's what we're meant to attain as well. We're on this journey to a heavenly homeland. We're on this journey, and we hope that as we look at her in her glory, we can say, this is how we want to be one day. And Mary is our spiritual mother who throughout our lives accompanies us and can encourage us, and she can give us the hope and inspiration during the struggles that we have throughout our lives. We turn to her as that mother who is always ready to listen. Just because she is in heaven now does not mean that she is somehow less available. In fact, she's more available, more accessible to us and for us in our need, that we might turn to her. She who is in that place we want to be can hear us and can help us. As we come this day, we know that Mary's intercession is something that we seek not only as we celebrate the Assumption, but every day, but in a particular way we're highlighting that glory, that triumph that her son now shares with her. The story of that boxer, well, that boxer was Oscar De La Hoya, who was 19 years old, weighed 132 pounds, and that was the only gold medal that we won on the boxing team that year. When he returned to Los Angeles, as the story goes, he went to the cemetery to give the gold medal to his mother. He just wanted her to share in his victory. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the light of the world to come. Amen. Inspired by the witness of God's love and care for us in Mary's Assumption, let us now ask for our needs.
For the Church, that we will imitate Mary, the model for all generations in bringing Christ into the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For public authorities, that they will work to eliminate all that divides people according to race, status, gender, or economics. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a greater appreciation and acknowledgement of the role of women in our society and our Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of our parish circle of prayer and for all those impacted by the coronavirus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those of us who have died will find eternal peace and joy with Mary and all the saints, especially Joseph and Edna Gillen, for whom we offer this Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We remember our brothers and sisters in Haiti who have been impacted by the terrible, terrible storm, the terrible earthquake that is impacting loss of life, loss of property. We keep them in our prayers. Lord, you have taken Mary into heavenly glory. We ask you to keep us in your love and, like Mary, lead us to share in the joy and triumph of your resurrection. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May this oblation, our tribute of homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your Church's coming to perfection, and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Amen.
give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously made holy, these gifts be brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Amen.
graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always." Let us offer each other a sign.
Having received
receive the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. A few announcements. Thank you for your weekly contributions. The baskets are at the doors. Take home a bulletin. There's a bulletin insert about our golf tournament. Many people have sent in their foursomes. If you're planning to golf, send that in. There's information about being a tea sponsor. You can have something put on a sign. It can be in memory of someone. Congratulations to someone, a business name. You'll see all that information. There's a golf tournament planning committee meeting on Monday at 6:30. Our cookout is next Saturday. If you haven't already done so, put your name on a piece of paper, throw it into the basket there. We'll know you're coming. Our faith formation program needs catechists. Please consider doing that after the 8:30 Mass tomorrow. So at 9:30, the two coordinators will be in the parish center to answer any questions you might have about that role of catechist. Next Sunday, we're going to try something. I'm calling it Name Tag Sunday. There'll be name tags, markers. First name on the name tag, it's going to help me get to know your name. It'll take me 72 times, but I will come to know your name after I hear it over and over and over again. But we'll do it next week. It's the Feast of St. Bernard, a good time to start. And it's that little mantra that you see that I put into the bulletin, and it's on the poster as you walked in, that we want to see a face and learn a name and then share a story. It's the way we love our neighbor. And finally, we have in our parish center right now after Mass a whole display of Catholic books. There's a woman who goes around the parishes. She brings a whole pile of books. They're for children, they're for adults, they're on study, Catholic Bible study, they're on saints, they're on spirituality, all different topics. It's nice to be able to see that. Maybe it's a gift from grandparent to a grandchild or something for yourself. But if you have the opportunity, just walk through the parish center, just take a minute to peruse what's there. I'm sure that you might find something that you would be very interested in. And so it's just an opportunity to bring all those books here to you to take a look at. And if you have a few minutes, stop by the parish center. And finally, I think I'm going to the beach tomorrow for the first time. And that little boy, my mother's voice is a cure in the water. How many of you grew up with that? There's a cure in the water on the Assumption. Oh my goodness, only a few of you. I went to look at the origin of that you go into the ocean on the Assumption. I think it goes back to when they had the blessing of the fleet very often for the Feast of the Assumption. It happened in a lot of European countries where they would bless the boats, and there was a cure because of the blessing in the water. At least that's as much as I can find out when I'm open to other ways of interpreting this that you might know. But in the old days, my mother would say, if you couldn't go to the ocean on that day, they'd bring a bottle, and you fill the bottle with water from the ocean and bring it back to the people in Providence who couldn't come down. Was this only my family? I don't know. Was this only my family that did this? All right, I guess something else to talk about. Stop by the book sale. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
And as we go forth, our closing hymn is Hail, Holy Queen.